evening between Chelsea and Brighton. Four changes for the Blues. Romelu Lukaku started his first league game since October the 16th. Lukaku, Christensen, Kovacic and Azpilicueta come in. Silva, Chalobah, Alonso and Conte. Brighton make three changes from their 2-0 win over Brentford. We assume that March and Veltman come in for Trossard, Webster and Wepu. Chelsea never lost a league game to Brighton, winning 10 of 12. Brighton have never scored in six away games versus Chelsea in the league. Promises to be entertaining in a battle at Stamford Bridge. Kick-off fast approaching in the 7:30 Premier League game this Wednesday evening between Chelsea and Brighton. Four changes for the Blues. Romelu Lukaku started his first league game since October the 16th. Lukaku, Christensen, Kovacic and Azpilicueta come in. Silva, Chalobah, Alonso and Conte. Brighton make three changes from their 2-0 win over Brentford. We assume that March and Veltman come in for Trossard, Webster and Wepu. Chelsea never lost a league game to Brighton, winning 10 of 12. Brighton have never scored in six away games versus Chelsea in the league. Promises to be entertaining in the battle at Stamford Bridge. Kick-off fast approaching in the 7:30 Premier League game this Wednesday evening between Chelsea and Brighton. Four changes for the Blues. Romelu Lukaku started his first league game since October the 16th. Lukaku, Christensen, Kovacic and Azpilicueta come in. Silva, Chalobah, Alonso and Conte. Brighton make three changes from their 2-0 win over Brentford. We assume that March and Veltman come in for Trossard, Webster and Wepu. Chelsea never lost a league game to Brighton, winning 10 of 12. Brighton have never scored in six away games versus Chelsea in the league. Promises to be entertaining in the battle at Stamford Bridge. Kick-off fast approaching in the 7:30 Premier League. Azpilicueta come in, Silva, Chalobah, Alonso and Conte. Brighton make three changes from their 2-0 win over Brentford. We assume that March and Veltman come in for Trossard, Webster and Wepu. Chelsea never lost a league game to Brighton, winning 10 of 12. Brighton have never scored in six away games versus Chelsea in the league. It was just to be entertaining in back the battle at Stamford Bridge. Kick-off fast approaching in the 7:30 Premier League.
Versus Chelsea in the league. Promises to be entertaining in back the battle at Stamford Bridge.
Azpilicueta come in, Silva, Chalobah, Alonso and Conte. Brighton make three changes from their 2-0 win over Brentford. We assume that March and Veltman come in for Trossard, Webster and Wepu. Chelsea never lost a league game to Brighton, winning 10 of 12. Brighton have never scored in six away games versus Chelsea in the league. Promises to be entertaining in back the battle at Stamford Bridge. Kick-off fast approaching in the 7:30 Premier League. Azpilicueta come in, Silva, Alonso and Conte. Brighton make three changes from their 2-0 win over Brentford. We assume that March and Veltman come in for Trossard, Webster and Wepu. Chelsea never lost a league game to Brighton, winning 10 of 12. Brighton have never scored in six away games versus Chelsea in the league. Chelsea's to be entertaining in back of the battle at Stamford Bridge. Kick-off fast approaching in the 7:30 Premier League.
Chelsea and Brighton. Kick-off fast approaching in the 7:30 Premier League game. This is Wednesday evening between Chelsea and Thank you. good enough. It's his fault. Chelsea had bodies in there. They were all onside as well. Just too much on it.
He may well look round at his caddy and say it was the wrong club, but it was still the wrong club and he hit it too
hard. I love how he looks at the coach.
There was nobody going to get to that from an attacking point of view. Even if there had been one or two late runs at the far post, unless they were about 8 foot tall, there's no way anybody gets near that.
I love how he looked at the bench to say, that wasn't me, was it?
Yeah, but, yeah. Of course it was.
Yes, it was, Callum.
Sometimes you just got to say, that was rubbish. Sorry about that, lads. Crazy. Crack on. Let's go.
Cucurella is in trouble. He's just given a free kick away. Mike Dean's punished him for a challenge. And it's a little talking to. It's nothing too frantic. As we see Mike Dean just have a word. The Chelsea player gone down here off the ball. It looks like Christensen. He's holding the legs firmly out and stretching the base of both feet. Whether it's another issue elsewhere, I hope it's not a head injury that he's maybe picked up further up the pitch. Has he not been feeling well? He does look unwell. You know, he looks like a pale it looks like he's been winded. Try to stretch out the back, maybe. I'm not too sure what, you know, no clear and obvious issue.
No, it could be a little strain of the base of the back, I think, at the moment. He doesn't look very comfortable at all, Christensen. They're talking into the microphones, and it looks like Chalabar's already stripped off and ready
both
to roll.
Feet,
so
whether it's he's putting a issue he elsewhere, putting a, I hope it's not a head injury.
Vest on just to go and warm up, but I wonder if it's something they knew about with Christensen already, and therefore, but Chalabar is certainly getting deep instructions on the sideline in terms of who he should be covering and what he should be doing. So it does look like there might be a change. I think this must be an existing injury for Christensen because of the speed that they've reacted to it suggests they knew that something was wrong, and it does look like it's something around the base of the back.
Very strange. Very strange indeed. Chelsea take the free kick. They've taken it back to Jorginho, who now has it and looks across midfield. He lays it off in towards Kovacic. Rudiger, as always, is playing like an ambitious centre-half. He goes back to Cam Hudson-Odoi, who pings it towards Kovacic. Was never going to get to that. It's a good job. Christensen's actually able to continue, but Chelsea have given the ball away. Here is Bissouma. He's got Morpé to his left. I thought he should have given it towards Morpé. He gives it to Lamptey, who's got Rudiger over his shoulder. And when you've got Christian, I know it's so hard to remember which player's injured, which is not, but you've got a player that's just had a back injury running backwards gingerly with Morpé alongside him, and you give it towards Rudiger, and Chelsea have got a huge let-off, but it was the fact that a poor pass, it was all their own doing, as here comes James. Oh, it's a wonderful challenge from Bissouma, and now Brighton are on their way again. I swear Brighton can maybe catch them cold. Chelsea's defence are so happy to come striding out of defence. You've got to nail them as soon as you possibly can. And it is into the feet now of Bissouma after halfway through this first half, with very little going on near halfway. It's a chance for Steve to hopefully get a bit more luck than I did and get a few more goal mouth chances and hopefully a goal.
Yeah, we said they might come at a premium this evening, and so it's proving so far. But you're absolutely bang on there, Tom, in terms of the last attack. You've got to go at Christensen. You've got to make him turn as well away. The ball around the back to Morpé would have made Christensen spin round. He would have had to have dealt with it on his wrong foot as well. That was definitely the option here. They come against Christensen again. Morpé can't get the ball out from under his feet, though. In the end, Christensen's able to make a challenge, but he is clearly coming off. There is no way for me he can carry on. But Lukaku at the other end of the field now, right-hand edge of the penalty area, two defenders in front of him. On the overlap comes Mount. Shot comes in, pushed away from Sanchez from his feet. Decent stop, fairly simple regulation save for the Brighton keeper. Plenty of power on the strike from Mount, but straight into his feet as Lukaku went away. Might have been tight on offside. It would have been checked VAR-wise had we gone to goal. Lovely little run in. Again, plenty of defenders around, but the shot's still on target.
Yeah, it's a good shot because I've seen a few keepers, you know, in these sort of games, he's got to perhaps have a look at the corner of his head to see what's coming from the other side. Is it Lukaku? Worry for Chelsea is that Reece James is now down and he looks in more pain than Christensen did. With Thomas Tuchel and the rest of his elite managers, I say that in inverted commas, have an issue with injuries, and they're complaining at the fixture schedule and they're complaining at the lack of subs, then this is going to add fuel to the fire. He's got two of his back three on the floor.
Absolutely, it's not looking good at all. That substitution immediately being indicated again on the sidelines. As you say, Christensen still doesn't look right at all, and we're 20 minutes away from half time, so it's not like Christensen can carry on as well and maybe and get some treatment at half time. Certainly a problem. But Reece James straight down, looks like it's the knee that they were starting to work on. James just gone on the floor, arm over his face, and it doesn't look too good at all. And as you say,
looks,
the substitution indication has been given by the physio.
It looks substantial, that he's in some pain. I'm not saying that. I'm no physio, and I wouldn't want to contemplate it anyway. But it's the challenge from Bissouma. He's taken a huge challenge. It's a great challenge, by the way. But it's the trailing leg that hits James's frailing leg in the air. It's the impact it looks. I hope it is just that, and it's a dead leg, and it's taking the wind out of his sails, because he can put no weight on that leg barely. What we're talking.
That's not clearly not a dead leg in the way that he's coming.
We're talking 1 foot at a time, slowly.
That's potentially we're looking ligaments here.
I know Chelsea have got a stat. Have they not got any medics nearby? A stretcher? Is anyone going to help him out?
Well, it looks like he'll just wander his way off. As it looks like Alonso's getting ready to come on, but that's a very slow walk off. I'm not even sure that is actually what caused the injury in terms of Bissouma's challenge, because he didn't seem to twist or anything as he hit. As you say, he landed heavily. But you would think that would be an impact injury, but that to me looks like a strain injury. The pain that he's in and the delicate way that they're taking him off the pitch doesn't look very good at all, I'm afraid to say, for Reece James. That could be a long-term one, unfortunately, from a Chelsea point of view. Christiansen's injury looks a bit more like a kind of, twinge of the back, something of that ilk, that he might be able to stretch out and be able to deal with. Alonso has come on, as we said, for Reece James. But as you say, two defenders against, from a Brighton point of view, you've got to attack quickly, for me, I would say.
Yeah, certainly so as well, just with a bit of that confusion of personnel. It's not a bad replacement though, Steve.
Now, Alonso comes on just after his birthday yesterday. Ball in towards the near post. Lukaku with the header, and Lukaku with the goal again. He powers the defenders away. It's not the greatest header you'll ever see, but he puts it down and across the keeper into the far corner. We said that Brighton needed to attack. Chelsea have taken the opportunity and scored the goal 1-0.
Yeah, brilliant header in terms of power. He's looking at as if something is being told, as if he's not being given. If I'm Lukaku, I'm very unhappy here. But I think with the way the game's going, Steve, I'm not sure this will stand. I don't know if they're going to punish him for they might even book him for a card for a swinging arm.
I think you're right, and I think it's because it's the other arm. I think they're battling with the left-hand side of it. They're both at it, but then the final swing round of the arm comes from Lukaku to the right-hand side. I think he's pointed goal. He's saying goal. I think they're saying, well, they were both battling for it. It's an accidental flailing arm then is the decision, and Lukaku gets the benefit of the doubt. I think that was the issue. We'll see it better from this angle, because with them behind, the first arm comes from Lukaku, then it's a grab. Yeah, there isn't actually a kind of movement of the elbow backwards. It's more a movement of the arm, and as he does so, yes, he catches the head of Mope, but I don't think there's anything particularly bad in it. I'm leaning with the referee on this one. I think they've got that one right. You've got to let players fight for the ball. Yes, he's been caught on the nose. Yes, he has been got. But I think they were both at it, grabbing each other. I'm going to give the attacker the benefit of the doubt.
Yeah, I'm happy with that call. I think the biggest thing for me is if Morpé doesn't want to get elbowed, don't dip your head and try and wrap your arms around someone that's 6 foot plus and is probably the biggest player on the pitch in terms of weight. Morpé is now moaning at the fourth official for the fact that he's hit him twice. This is what I think. Just sometimes what they try and do is they try and get a hold, hope he gets hit and goes to ground, or he can't win a free, he can't score now, he's hit me. I'm more than happy with that. I just thought, because it wasn't the left arm he hit him with, the referee would pull him. But overall, I think it might even help the game as well, with Brighton trying to attack. Here they come.
Yeah, ball through now again, challenged by Christiansen, who stretches out. Still doesn't look very comfortable, but he gets there in front of Mope and clears the ball away. Ball is out of play for a throw into Brighton. They will feel hard done by, of course they will. As you said, for me, there's not an elbow out there from Lukaku. It's a flailing arm that catches him. Lukaku knows what he's doing, don't get me wrong. I know he's battling for it. He's big and strong and old enough to know what to do in those kind of situations, Lukaku, and he does it well. As you said, if you're going to battle with him, well, you've got to battle to the end. Mope didn't on that occasion. It gave him the space to do it. As I said, I'll lean with the referee. Usually, if it's against the goalkeeper, of course, it would have been a free kick, but against the defender, hard lines. Get on with the game. Let's battle for it. let's let players fight for the ball.
Yeah, if it's Sanchez, it's a two-game ban for Lukaku.
Absolutely.
Give a goal back. Goalkeepers union, stand by each other.
They will look at that and say clear foul. From a Chelsea point of view, they will say clear goal. But so we will sit on a Chelsea side on this occasion. Not that I say that too often. I like the underdog, as you know, but I will lean towards the home side on this occasion. The ball is cleared away by Brighton. Let's get back on with the game. Lukaku is now going to battle for everything. He's just knocked Christensen out of the way. He's now decided, well, if we can hit and punch each other and push each other, then I'll have a bit of that as well. But he's got to be careful.
Yeah, I think it's great, this, for Chelsea. I mean, it's great anyway, taking the lead at home. But with what's just happened with a couple of injuries, a few worries, just to have the nerve settled down a little bit. You know, if Brighton go and score first, you've just lost your defender. He's been walked, helped off by two or three physios. You know, even the team, Steve, will maybe think, right, hold on, we've just lost Chilwell. We have now lost him. We'll just break off because more pace coming forward. As you say, it's a bit of a lunging China Christensen who is going through the walls at the minute. He's slow as can be to get to his feet off the floor, but he's soldiering on. Whether they're going to give him some spray to carry on. But as you said then, he isn't 100% comfortable. Every time the game stops, he goes back down again on his haunches. He's leaning over again. Can you really afford to do that with your price centre-half against Brighton for 65 minutes?
I really wouldn't risk it. I don't know why they're not taking him off at the moment. As you say, he's getting out of it because of his quality and the pace that he does have, even though the injury is there, as Cucurella comes away down the left-hand side. Mount screams that it came off the Brighton man last, but the referee, Mike Dean, from the angle he's looking at, will give the decision against the defence. Say that Mount does have a case there. May not have flicked off him, but from the referee's point of view, it would have looked like it certainly did. So we'll give the referee the benefit of the doubt on this occasion. Corner kick to Brighton, whipped in towards the near post. Poor corner, though, easily headed away by Aspilicueta, first man. It's straight out of play for a Brighton throw-in, midway inside the Chelsea half, left-hand side. Cucurella will be the man to take it. 33 minutes gone. Chelsea 1, Brighton 0. Lukaku with the only goal of the game. It will be classed as controversial. It will certainly be seen that way. But for me, certainly a goal that should have been given as Brighton worked their way through throw-ins down the left-hand side of Chelsea. Cucurella comes for it again. Gloved figure this time. Looks to throw the ball in. Bounces it up towards Marge. Bobbles it a couple of times on the chest. Hooks it into the area. Mendy has to be careful as it drops under his crossbar. But he's under no pressure as he takes the catch. And from a Brighton point of view, yeah, if that ball's up in the air, yes, you think that Mendy's going to get it. But you've got to at least try and get him under pressure inside his own 6-yard box.
Even just run at him just so he's got someone in his eye lines, David. I'm sure most keepers would not want to appreciate just having someone in the vision. As here comes Mount, turns inside. Cucurella runs into the box, but Lallana gets there first. I mean, if I'm Chelsea, of course, you want to try and take Christensen off. But at the same time, you can understand it. To use two of your subs inside 40 minutes is a bit of a disaster. But if you're Brighton, it's such a shame you don't have a Lukaku-type build up front to just sit on Christensen's shoulder, whip the ball into the box just constantly. You know, I just wouldn't trust him to make a last-ditch tackle or a last-ditch block, to be honest, because, you know, he isn't 100%. You know, they've got the options back there. I will say, for Chelsea's point of view, Steve, since we swapped over and since the goal, Brighton have done nothing. You know, we had a few flashes, didn't we? We haven't had anything in the last 5 minutes from Brighton.
Yeah, they've certainly been pushed back out wide, particularly now. Aspilicueta's pushed forward. I think Chelsea have decided the press has to be a little bit higher on the basis that they're struggling with defenders just coming on, with Alonso off the bench and with Christensen injured. The midfield has taken control of the game, pushed Brighton a little further back and forced them to play longer balls towards Maupay. And at the moment, even with Christensen on about 70% of his power, his experience means that he's in front of Maupay all the time, although he's failed to clear here. Maupay's picked it up, hooks it in towards the penalty area. Shot comes in on the turn, cleared away on this occasion. McAllister got the space just inside the area, but it was blocked off before the strike could get towards Mendy. And then it's up with Kovacic on the left-hand side. Great ball to Lukaku, and suddenly there's a 3-on-2, but unfortunately the layoff from Lukaku was the right idea towards Callum Hudson-Odoi, but he didn't really get the connection on it, just looped up in the air. And in the end, Brighton are able to come back and cover. But at the moment, Brighton are defending more desperately than stoutly at times, but it's just about working.
Yeah, I mean, it's all a bit desperate. I think it's a great word to use around Lukaku, isn't it? It's just getting the ball off him any way, shape or form. But you look at Brighton's backline itself, that isn't their first choice defence, is it? Let's be honest. You've got no Dunk, no Duffy. It's a lot weaker than they had last year when they had Ben White at the fold. So they've done it tough as well. And, you know, I'm sure Dunk could have more success against Lukaku. So it's not easy. I still think there's a few more goals in this because of the openness we've seen, the few injuries we've seen. But I think you hit the nail on the head. chances. You know, well, we might get a goal, so I don't think we're going to get a boatload of chances from either team. It'll be few and far between, and that's pretty much been the case. Yes, we've had four attempts on target from Chelsea, but none from Brighton, despite that endeavour. And you'd actually say they're probably the most eye-catching two moves have been Brighton to Lamptey, and yet what have they got to show for it? You know, absolutely nothing at the minute.
Yeah, Lamptey's sitting back a little more now because Alonso is in there, which means he'll not come forward as far. Hudson-Odoi then provides the problem for Brighton down the left-hand side that they have to contend with. We shall see. Chelsea one up, as we said, 36 minutes gone. As Brighton look for an equaliser down the left-hand side, marched as well, tricks and turns his way, edge of the penalty area, then a poor ball into the box is cleared away. Shot comes in from distance, straight at Mendy, though, in the end, as it bounces up into the orange shirt of the Chelsea keeper. But at least one or two strikes from Brighton coming into play now. It's Bissouma's strike, not having the power or the direction just on that occasion.
Yeah, it's that could have took a nick. It could have been zipped off the surface. It's a slick surface out there. It's worth a go, I think. Here they come again.
And Bissouma in space again. Might fancy his chances for another shot. Can't get it onto his right foot. He tries to go with a 1-2 from Morpay. And there's a rather flop on the floor of the defender. Good save from Mendy as the ball spun away to Lallana. He smashes a shot. He's absolutely furious with the Chelsea defender that went down. It's a rather pathetic fall inside the box from, I don't know if it was Kovacic or somebody. I'll check in a minute.
Jorginho,
actually, who dropped to the floor under very little at all on that occasion. Really poor effort from Jorginho. We said about the power and pace that others have in that side. He just fell on the floor. Lallana with a good strike, good save. And then a few volley of words towards Jorginho and the Brazilian to get up and get on with the game.
Every commentary we do, we always try and praise the ones that that don't. You know, us good Yorkshire folks, I think great refereeing. To just say get on with things. Here come Brighton again.
Yeah, the corner's cleared away. Second cross comes in and Lukaku flings himself back towards his own goal line on the right-hand edge of his six-yard box to head the ball behind for another corner to Brighton. The pressure is starting to come now from the Seagulls. This is better from them since they've gone behind to that Lukaku goal at the other end of the field. They'll perhaps do the short corner routine this time to change the angle because the first corners in have been pretty poor so far. Need better delivery. With such big men in there, of course, we know all about Dan Burn, but there's plenty of others around as well. He's whipped in towards the near post. Lukaku with the header, but straight up in the air, drops for Lallana, tries to take it on the volley on the edge of the box, but he hooks it well wide, and again, another glimpse of an opportunity just fizzles out for Brighton.
Well, that's what we were just saying then, though, about getting under Mendy, getting in his eye line. He's got 10 shirts that he can see before he's even looking at the ball. No wonder he hits. You know, he has to just walk up to that and pretend there's no one there, but... You can't. I don't think it's human nature to do it. You've got the worry that you're going to kick somebody, they're going to hurt you. You just can't, you know, he might have even been better off just trying to control it. I don't think a Chelsea player would have got to him, to not let him control it. Well, I'm sure they'd have blocked him for the shot, but it's, you know, I wouldn't even class it as a half chance. It's so difficult. But, Chelsea have managed to weather the storm of injuries for now, but they haven't created too much. They find they might have something here.
Here comes Hudson-Odoi heading across the field, and then his sat-nav goes off and he turns himself all the way around and gets completely lost, and then miscontrolled as well by Kovacic in midfield. Rather messy end.
His sat-nav took him down a one-way street.
I don't know where.
What was he doing?
I think there was a river there that he suddenly found himself in front of. As the ball is down towards Lamptey, that's a rather hefty challenge from Rudiger. He's probably rather lucky there that he may well have got the ball, Mr. Rudiger, but you were also off your feet when that challenge started, I think. Referee is going to do no more than have a word, perhaps. He's looking at it, Rudiger. There will be a yellow card here. At the moment, it will be nothing more. And I think that is literally because Rudiger jumps in, both feet off the ground, it looked like, from the first look. Doesn't necessarily catch the player, but it's still a careless challenge, and he can complain all he likes. I think the referee is absolutely spot on. If there's no connection, that's still careless.
I don't know why he's doing it. He's got the beating of Lamptey on the shoulder badge. Why are you trying to... Why are you doing it? I don't understand. Why?
I've no idea.
And were those feet apart? They didn't look apart to me. They look together to me, to be honest. I think he's got pretty lucky, I'll be honest.
He's a lucky man. He doesn't connect with Lamptey. Let's put it that. If he connects with Lamptey there, he's gone. That's a red card, no question. But a yellow, as he didn't, really. But he still jumped in with both feet. I think he needs to stop complaining as the ball comes in from the free kick then towards the far post. Who's there again? It is Rudiger himself, I think. It is, who heads it away. seeing if he got the final flick off, and Rüdiger is the one getting the applause. It must have flicked off his head and behind for a corner kick. So from a free kick to a corner, which McAllister will go across to take. 5 minutes to go to the break. Chelsea still leading by a goal to nil. But Brighton looking better over the last 10 minutes. But it's another set-piece opportunity. They haven't really created anything so far from these set-pieces directly from them. They have from second balls then around the penalty area. This time we'll see if they can create something with the first ball in. One arm raised from McAllister, right footed again. It comes in towards the near post, and then he punches it away on his far left. He takes it on the chest, tries a shot, never really gets over the top of it though, and it loops up and over the crossbar. And again, same thing, nothing from the first chance, a half chance from the second ball.
Yeah, again, I looked at this. I don't think he ever really fancied it. Again, look at the players. Alonso, Morpé's behind him. And I think he's onside, and there's a reason why Lamptey's apologised 3 times. He realises that that pass should have gone. Morpé's then got a chance to shoot, he's got a chance to cross. But again, no one ever tells you that on computer games or in your dreams, that you can pass a 5-yard pass. He's chested it down, I can score from 20 yards out, and my name's on the scoreboard. It's that little bit of hope that kills you. Hindsight and the realisation of where his teammate was is what set him apart there.
Saw the headlines of first ever Brighton goal in the league at Stamford Bridge after 12 attempts, I think, between the two sides, 6 of them at Stamford Bridge in the league. Not a goal on the score sheet so far. As we see a replay again of that tackle from Rüdiger, the more you see it, the worse it gets. 1983, that's a heck of a challenge. 2021, that's a clear yellow card.
Yeah, I mean, I don't personally look at that, and I don't get too annoyed. I think we're of the era that, you know, the game's gone a little bit soft, but the rules have been the rules for years. It hasn't exactly come about, and he can have no complaints. I think he's tried to complain as long as he possibly can without saying much. He's in, to say he's in utter disbelief at the card, almost just trying to take the attention off it. I think if he goes away sheepishly, he gives himself up. But he wasn't really chelping off. There was more aspect of question and others that were trying to defend him. I think he knows he's done wrong there. My biggest issue for Chelsea is why do it? Just shoulder barge him in the touch. Done. Win a throw, move on. And that would be a bit of an annoyance there. Especially when, if your manager, if you're his manager, you've lost your centre half, you've got another centre half carrying a back injury, and then you've got a centre half nearly gets.
About 5 minutes or so, Brighton have the better of it. They come away again here. Morpé even tries to get the ball through to McAllister. He can't quite do so though. Chelsea break away in the opposite directions. Pulisic goes down that right hand side. Lukaku goes out there as well, but doesn't get the ball as the American comes back across field. Kovacic will tidy up. It's out wide to Alonso. A little bit of possession spell here from Chelsea, which is something they haven't had. They just want to ease themselves down towards half-time. A minute or so to go of the normal 45 minutes, plus whatever the referee adds on. Should be a minute or two for the couple of injuries that we've seen, at least. As Lukaku's goal still separates the two sides. Chelsea have now scored 8 headed goals in the Premier League, more than anybody else, and 7 from corners as well, which again is more than anybody else in the Premier League. So you see the quality of the balls into the area and have created the opportunities in the first half of the season for this Chelsea side. As they failed to get the ball that time into Lukaku successfully, and the ball is with Sanchez, just on the edge of his own box as we tick into the 45-minute mark. Still waiting to confirm the number of minutes to be played in addition. As Brighton look for a little something before half-time, there's certainly been signs for Seagulls fans that there could be something in this game. They've managed to quell a couple of Chelsea storms at various times, having conceded the goal. What they will see as controversial circumstances. The ball forward here, and Mendy comes out of his area, just plays the percentage, just plays the ball out of play for a throw-in, rather than trying to be too clever there, Edward Mendy. 4 minutes of stoppage time will be played. Throw-in has been taken by Brighton down their right-hand side. Ball is back across again, but it comes off a Brighton player last, and Rüdiger is able just to allow the ball to run out of play, and it all ends up as a bit of a mess in the end with Veltman down there on the right-hand side, not really creating a good opportunity. And Mr. Potter is not impressed by that Brighton attack, I think we can safely say.
Well, he was trying to encourage them, and I couldn't understand what they were trying to do. It was a simple throw-in from Lallana. He then runs laterally across the box to try and get a return pass, and Moda booted it at him, and it was, you know, it had to be delicate, and he didn't do that. Had he passed it, Chelsea were in a bit of trouble, but they had the fine margins as Chelsea give away a free kick, a handball by Jorginho, or is it Azpilicueta? Both players looking a bit disgruntled. But I get the impression that half-time will be good for both these two teams, Steve. Sort of loft our way a little bit.
Yeah, they certainly have. And Chelsea, a bit like Brighton were earlier on in the game, just getting that last challenge in, making sure that Brighton don't have any clear-cut opportunities at least, even though Brighton are dominating possessions. Basuma spins away from Lukaku and gets an exclamation of joy from my right-hand side about the quality of the turn, and then a poor ball forward by Veltman, easily cleared away but straight out of play for a throw into Brighton, just inside the Chelsea half, right-hand side. And it will be Veltman to take it again. See the possession stats last 5 minutes, no surprise, 65% from Brighton, the dominating possession, but they can't get a clear-cut opportunity at the moment, as they have possession here with Basuma through the centre. He drives past a couple of Chelsea midfielders and then comes up against a defensive wall, plays it out wide to Lamptey, who's got players in front of him. He finds Lamalana on the edge of the box, ball breaks for Maupay to McAllister, might fancy his shot, should get a strike in, he does. But it's straight down the throat of Mendy, who takes it at the second attempt above his head.
It's not a bad shot, is it? I don't think you can criticise that shot really at all. It's powerful, it's on target, it's forced to save. But I did wonder if the pass should have just been, you know, pinged out to the left-hand side of that that box, give it to March. He's then got a chance to cross it to four players. I just think sometimes when you are Brighton, you're pretty much asking all your putting all your eggs in the basket of that shot being unbelievable. Or it taking a deflection. I think sometimes when you're playing a better team, get a percentage ball into the box and get your striker attacking it, especially with a centre-half that's got a bad back.
Absolutely, as the ball is picked up again by Brighton, but they're inside their own half, 2.5 minutes or so of the 4 minutes of stoppage time to be played, as Lamptey turns himself inside out, tries to get the ball forward. It spins off Modair in the end and ends up played by Maupay out wide onto that left-hand side. March, Cucurella's gone on the overlap. March decides to cross instead. It's pushed out by McAllister, but not really into the path of Maupay. It was just lobbed up for him to try and do something with it. He just had to put his head in there where it hurts, but in the end it just bounces harmlessly through to Mendy again.
Yeah, but again, just it's a little bit better, isn't it? You're asking a few more questions of the defence. I think Brighton will be happy, but at least Potter's got something, Steve, to build on after his half-time team talk, as long as they don't concede a second. For Tuchel, you'd want more. If you were a Chelsea fan, would you be massively entertained tonight? I'm not sure you would. You'd be happy enough, but you'd be still a little bit coy on what could come in the second half.
And Brighton have possession, but it's inside their own penalty area with Sanchez, who will just roll it to Byrne on his left-hand side. He comes out of the penalty area, looks forward, not really too much movement in front of him, so he's allowed to walk forward another 10 yards, and he gives the ball away. He's rather fortunate that he spins off Pulisic and back to Basuma. Out wide onto that left-hand side, where March will come across again. He finds McAllister, who tries to push a ball down to Cucurella down that left-hand side, but he's well marshalled on this occasion by Azpilicueta, and Chelsea are able to clear. And they've gone back towards Rudiger now. And Chelsea will look to ease out this 45 minutes now. We've played the 4 minutes with Rudiger in possession and Mike D.
Welcome along then to our coverage of this Premier League encounter. We are currently at Chelsea 1, Brighton 0 as we restart the second half. And we've had a change. Trevor Chalobah has come on at centre-half, which we believe is for Andreas Christensen, because at times Andreas Christensen was walking as if he'd just done a London Marathon before playing tonight. Very gingerly at times, hobbling about. And it all started from an incident around 22, 23 minutes in when he went down first. He looked like he was going to be replaced. Chalobah was actually stripped off. Steve mentioned that, myself, Tomlin and Steve Pearson. Steve mentioned it alongside me, and then we looked up and Reece James was down, and they've had to carry on without him. If you're just rejoining us, Romelu Lukaku's goal is the difference between the two teams. It is Chelsea 1, Brighton 0. The Chelsea team is Mendy, Rudiger, Chalobah, Azpilicueta, Hudson-Odoi, Jorginho, Kovacic and James. Pulisic, Lukaku and Mount. As for break off Brighton, will just break off a chance, pardon me, as Chalobah clears across. Brighton go with Sanchez, Lamptey, Veltman, Byrne, Cucurella, Lallana, Bissouma, March, Moda, McAllister and Morpey. Slow this from Chelsea. They've given the ball away for a second time. It's now with Alana. Cruyff turned his way out of trouble. He lays it back to Cucurella, who sweeps it wide to March. March running up Pulisic. He'll fancy his chances there, and he turns past him. Lays it off to Alana, who scoops it up. It's over the head towards goal. Header. It's off the top of the roof of the net. And Moda's got his head in his hands, and there's a good reason for it. An ever so slightly more delicate touch. That's one apiece.
Yeah, very, very unlucky on that occasion. It was nicely worked by Brighton. March, who's tricking and turning, they don't really know how to cover him down that left-hand side, and he's creating opportunities. Lallana just lifts a percentage ball into the box, and Moda does really well. Actually comes off his shin and spins up in the air, flicks off the top of the crossbar. Mendy's lost if that drops underneath. No criticism of the keeper. He's just got no chance at all. It's dropping out of the sky down towards the crossbar. Unfortunately for him, it flicks the top of it and goes over rather than just dipping under. But really strong start from Brighton. You know, there have been these changes for Chelsea defensively. They've got to make the most of them now, Brighton. The danger is at the other end. Here comes Lukaku.
Yeah, he's got to be careful of Brighton because they are going to go for it. It's a bit of a free hit, really, when nobody expected you to go for get any results tonight anyway. I was going to be up against it. They were heavy outsiders. But Chelsea have had to change two of their back line. Got players playing out of position. You never know what you can do as Pulisic gets at Hudson-Odoi. He's going to try and drive forward. He looks to the far post. Cucurella gets nowhere near it. Shot cross comes in. Takes a deflection off the legs of March. And it is behind for a Chelsea corner. 3 minutes gone of the second half.
Yeah, better stuff from Chelsea then, just to wake up a little bit in this half. They've been on the back foot, but have finally got themselves into a more attacking situation from their point of view with the defensive changes they've had to make. Second goal could be key here. Get it nice and early and then be able to sit in a little, cover that defence in more depth.
Yeah, here comes Mount's ball in towards the head of Lukaku. He just heads it over. He's got his head in his hands. He can't believe it. I think he's taken it from Rudiger as well. Lukaku, though, in disbelief, unless he's been caught by a stray arm, but he had his head in his hands, he was sort of leaning over. Really a big chance that for Chelsea to put pressure on. It just solely killed the tactics of Potter at the start of the second half. You sent your team out, they concede after 4 minutes of the second half, and game planning shredded up and started again. But Chelsea, a little deep here, it's out to Rudiger. Alonso on the left-hand side, not really an option. Here now is Kovacic driving forward. He flicks the pass. Oh, it's a no-look pass. Looking one way, then the other. Mount goes down in the box. It's a pretty hefty fall. He goes down. In fact, it's Pulisic. Well, I'll be honest. If that's a dive, he's done very well. I thought there was a trailing leg. He really did seem to fall over. Pulisic, he's in more shock that he's not. But he hasn't gone ballistic, which maybe suggests that it's not as strong.
There's a nibble. Let's put it that way from Veltman. More than anything else, yes, there is contact. Enough to knock Pulisic over? No, absolutely not in that way. There is an element of dive to it as well, I'm afraid to say, and I think that's what the referee's seen. There is a nibble from Veltman. It's not enough to bring him down, though.
It's great reactions from Pulisic, because he really has gone for... You know, he's really... The speed he's gone down at, for me, suggested that the power of the challenge was pretty strong, but as you say, I think he's seen the leg sort of dangling. And while he's being kicked, I'd have him in my synchronised swimming team. I know that as the ball's played forward to Kovacic. It's cleared away. Chelsea have been caught on the edge of their own box now three times. Mendy hasn't got a total control over it. But again, when you've got a new back three or five, whatever Chelsea play, it's rather confusing. Communication's not exactly ideal, but he's just not looked up and seen Morpé putting pressure on him. I can understand what he's trying to do, Steve. He's trying to play it wide to Alonso. They've got a two-on-one. The idea is perfect, but there's a man in a lime green kit running at you.
Kovacic was the ball out. I don't know why he didn't just roll it to the left-hand side. Kovacic was in space. There was plenty of room. I think that was one where Mendy had got something in his head and decided not to change it in that sense and not to try and be clever, but there was a much more simple ball to his left-hand side. He's got away with it. He'll take the plaudits, I'm sure, at some point from a save or a clearance, but that wasn't great from Mendy.
Yeah, Pulisic has given a foul away. He's got to be careful here. Doesn't need to boot the ball away. He's brought down March, who should be apologising towards Neil Morpé, because he had... This is the thing for me for Brighton. They're sometimes a bit too cute. He had the chance to swing the ball into the box, get it in the penalty area. You've given Neil Morpé absolutely nothing. He was breaking free. I know he might not score, but what's to say the defender doesn't kick it in the back of the net? I just think allowing Chelsea to put five bodies behind the ball is just stupid.
Yeah, there was a gap there to play it into. It was the old corridor of uncertainty, wasn't it? In between goalkeeper and defender. It was there as the option for March, but he chose not to take it.
Yeah, Maupay's just pointing at McCarthy to go near post as a potential flick. He's now making his way towards that sort of area. Can he get there first? Ball's going to come in. Mendy punches it clear. Don't know how much he saw of that because Jorginho was coming across his body. If he did get short-sighted and blindsided, I think he's done the right thing. But now they've taken it short. March to the far post, headed away by Alonso. Only as far as Bissouma, who's got to it Hudson-Odoi. Now he's trying to race forward. The pace of Hudson-Odoi is frightening. Lamptey's likewise. Now he gets it across towards Pulisic. Pulisic has to take it past Cucurella. It's great defending from Cucurella. Positioning is second to none. He's no slouch either. And Brighton are already inside the Chelsea half. Sonny March has got to be quick here. He needs to get the ball away. But a bit of class from both teams, Steve, from attacking and defending. We saw the best of both.
Yeah, Cucurella is superb, as you say. He didn't dive in, just waited, guess what Pulisic was going to do, and he read it and dealt with it really well. Then at the other end of the field, a little bit of frustration for me. You know that Pulisic is out of the equation, so you're 2-on-2 down the left-hand side, and March dallies a little, gives Pulisic time to come back and make the challenge when really he should have been driving on with Cucurella to go, OK, let's go 2-on-2 down this left-hand side, because Jorginho had pulled across. I think he saw Jorginho, thought there might be something inside. It wasn't there. The best option was still out wide.
Yeah, Maupay gets it across to March. 7 minutes gone in this second half. March trying to get past Pulisic, swings the ball, and it's a powerful cross. Alonso leans into it. Mendy comes flying off his line, almost as if he's going to try and take control. Bissouma picks the ball up, goes for goal! And it's down the throat of the keeper. Mendy saves. It's a corner.
Yeah, good strike, wasn't it? Beautiful crossing by March. That was the best of him that we saw after criticising him on the last attack. Beautiful crossing. Unfortunately for him, nobody attacking. It's well dealt with by Alonso. I'm not sure why Mendy tries to get involved in that sense, but he's back on his line quickly. Good strike. Straight down the keeper's throat, fortunately.
I think Mendy puts Alonso off by just running at him and screaming at him. And then I think that's why his pass is a lot shorter than it should be. I mean, if you're going to come claim... I just think you're putting pressure on you. I've not been impressed by either keeper tonight in terms of commanding of their penalty areas, as Brighton's corner's taken towards Byrne, who heads it back into the box, cleared away by Rudiger, only up into the air, but this time Pulisic gets his foot through it. Chelsea's furthest player forward is Callum Hudson-Odoi, and Lamptey now recovers possession inside the Brighton half. I do like Callum Hudson-Odoi. I think I would like to see him get a club where he actually plays week in, week out as an actual winger. His pace, for me, would get him into so many good areas. Unfortunately, he plays for Chelsea, who have six or seven sort of players of his ilk. But it is a frustration. Man City, by the way, are leading 1-0. Phil Foden scored in London against Brentford. 10 minutes gone of this second half. We've been speaking about Yves Bissouma, me and Steve, and suggesting that this could be his last year with Brighton. He's a player that is starting to stand out like a bit like a sore thumb at the moment for Brighton in terms of his quality. Here comes Alonso on the attack with Chelsea. It's in towards Mount. He tries to turn around his marker. It's really poor from Mount, and he's now putting his arms up in the air. There's a sniper at one end of the ground at Stamford Bridge. As Chalabar gets underneath it, heads it forward. Maupay tried to read that. Jorginho's going to try and use his strength. His arm puts McAllister in a headlock, but McAllister rides a challenge. Brighton have certainly upped the tempo in this second half, and it's got them into so many better areas. March gets it now, and manages to put a ball into a box. It's another going dangerous ball into the penalty area. It is cleared away. Brighton's fans cheer as they manage to get their team into an attacking zone, but I've noticed everything for Brighton's been put on like a fast-forward mode. Every free kick's taken quickly, every corner's taken quickly, and it's causing Chelsea a few issues.
Yeah, the pace of the game has picked up. They've also pushed a little further forward, but that's creating gaps. Now they've lost the ball.
Yeah, Hudson-Odoi from Lukaku. He's got options to his left, including Mount. Tried to roll it through his legs. It's really good defending from Veltman. How much he knew about it, I don't know. But Hudson-Odoi has got his head in his hands in frustration, because I think if he'd like to have the ability to rewind time, he'd rewind that and just carry on going to goal and shoot himself. Veltman covered that as best he possibly could. The pass, though, was so easy for Veltman to at least stick his leg out to.
Yeah, it became very obvious that Hudson-Odoi didn't want to go straight for goal. I'm afraid a little bit too early. As you said, you've got to take a decision one way or the other, but not show your hand. And he did put his hand on the table far too early there and gave Veltman the opportunity to sit in, not gamble, and therefore take the opportunity to take the ball.
Yeah, Maupay's going to come through on goal. Shot comes in. Oh, it's just wide. a ball through from McAllister. He gets it, does more, but he takes it round Rudiger. He goes for goal. It must be a whisker wide. He cannot believe it hasn't hit the back of the net. This is miles better as a spectacle. 57 minutes in, Chelsea 1, Brighton 0.
Yeah, it's what we said. We thought it might change in the second half. They might have just have worked each other out a little bit and one or two opportunities start to come. Brighton, as we said, have pushed forward. Lovely strike from Morpe. He's really unlucky on that occasion that it doesn't end up through on goal, as we see the chance again from Hudson-Odoi on our screens as he raced away. Again, he just made it too obvious that he was going to pass, and Veltman said, OK, well, I'll sit in here then and see if I can stop it, which he did. Thomas Tuchel is furious as he turns away. Hudson-Odoi knows that the opportunity is gone, but great chances are either end. March is now getting more and more space down the left-hand side. Chelsea, it is now, who need to reset and try and counter this Brighton press.
Yeah, Lamptey comes forward. That's an awful challenge from Kovacic. It's going to be a yellow card, surely. He's adamant he's got a touch of the ball. I think he just kicked Tariq Lamptey up in the air, and yeah, he gets a card. How he's got the cheek to try and plead his innocence, I do not know.
It was a very short plea, I think, is the honest answer. He did get the ball, there's absolutely no question, but he also took the player as well at the same time. For me, we'll see again on the replay. Yeah, takes the player. Tiniest of touches, if anything, on the ball. And I'm afraid to say it doesn't matter now. Yeah. Whether you get the ball or not is largely irrelevant. It's about the intent. It's about the way you challenge. That's a clear
free. I can understand why he's got annoyed, because all he will have felt at first is the ball move.
Yes.
But maybe he didn't feel that 5'2" centre right back alongside him go flying up into the air over the top. We'll have to see as Chelsea prepare to defend this set piece. McAllister is more of a classy operator to try and deliver, but it perhaps suits a left foot. But here's McAllister, floats it to the edge of the 6-yard box. Good hands from Edouard Mendy, really good hands. He's a big man, at full stretch. If he spills that, someone's got to tap in.
Yeah, that was not easy at all, the way the pace on the ball came in. I was loving watching Dan Burn against Mason Mount on the edge of the box. Whoever decided Mason Mount was the man to mark Dan Burn must have been in for the comedy factor. That sounds like a cracker joke from a few days ago, doesn't it, that one? But it kind of worked on the basis that he wrestled him to the ground for a little while on the edge of the box and kept him away from the ball. But as you said, excellent work from Mendy. Difficult ball to take. Took it perfectly.
Yeah, Hudson-Odoi towards the far post. Lamptey heads clear. Only as far as McAllister. He's beaten to it by Kovacic, but Lamptey gets it first. Overruns it, though, and Rudiger comes across to Chelsea's aid. And the Blues now recover possession. Rudiger inside to Azpilicueta. He lays it out towards the right-hand side for Hudson-Odoi, who's getting a bit more joy, a bit more space. Lukaku comes short for a layoff. Hudson-Odoi's pass is poor for the second time in a row in an attacking situation. Here, Jorginho lays it into Lukaku. Brighton can't afford to let Lukaku have a free touch towards the edge of his own box. They do. And now coming away with it is March. Lukaku's chasing him down. March rolls it inside. Effortlessly pass to Morpé. Issue for Brighton is they've got nobody on the right-hand side. So McAllister slows it right down. Gives it to Veltman. He goes through a return pass. Oh, where is Rudiger? He goes round to McAllister. Mendy comes off his line. He tips it away. Morpé coming on for the attack. Shot comes in. Rudiger saves. Gets a block to it. His right leg sticks out. Whether Antoine Rudiger's out of position, it's a brilliant pass. I think the defenders got caught ball watching two or three times now in the second half. That's a beautiful ball forward, but the gap is huge. That should never be as big as that, but fair play to Brighton. They're taking this game to them.
Absolutely, and you look at the opportunity there as the attack came about. 8 Chelsea defenders back, plenty of players in numbers, as you say. Shouldn't have been any spaces at all. Chalabar and Rudiger both ball watching at the same time. Nobody picks up the simple run from McAllister, leads to the corner.
Yeah, ball towards the far post, headed back into the ground by Byrne. It's going to be flicked away by Chalabar. Only as far as Cucurella, whose beautiful first touch makes sure that Brighton can still attack. He decides to cross it to the far post. There's nobody there. Eventually towards the corner flag, McAllister appears. Laid off to the edge of the box for Lamptey. Lamptey turns away from Lukaku too easily. He's going to go for goal. Digs out a shot. It's dragged wide. And Tariq Lamptey's frustrations in front of goal continue. Chelsea 1, Brighton 0. But already, though, 15 minutes of the second half gone, which suggests that we're having a decent game here. It's flowing, but it's flying by for me.
Yes, if there's one thing that Lamptey needs to work on, it's making that left foot something not just for standing on, I'm afraid to say, because that's twice he's now got in the area, hasn't got a decent strike on with his left foot. You could tell he didn't want to take that shot on. He was looking for another option around the edge of the penalty area. I know it's your swinger, but you've got to have a go at it to some extent in that sense. He's got to work on that, because a lot of the time now, fullbacks are expected to come inside and create opportunities and be two-footed. That's a disappointment in what is a good position for Brighton, and it's the second time it's happened in this game so far.
Yeah, and I think he's got into some good areas and just snatched, just gone, oh, well, I'll hit it and see what happens, rather than any real thought behind it. You know, it's the opposite to what we've seen with the Chelsea fullbacks this season. They've been stars of the show, haven't they? Alonso, Chilwell, James, they've all been three top players. As the boys play back by McAllister, Cucurella gets it, he drives forward, it's a poor pass. We've been praising him in the build-up, we've been praising him during the game, and he has just kicked the ball out of play when it was a really ambitious opportunity, a really good, strong opportunity to drive forward into some good areas of the pitch. But no good on that occasion from the young Brighton left-back who arrived from La Liga this season. As we see, the ball played in the line by Azpilicueta. Floated over the top by Brighton looking for Morpé. He's going to be turned away and out of play for a Brighton throw. Morpé's got his hands on the ball. He's going to let March take it, surely. He's the only centre-forward. Brighton can't afford their entire team to be into attacking areas on the left-hand side. Alana, still a classy operator on Alana. So we're gifted with both feet. I think his move to Brighton probably worked out better than most thought. He has had a few injury worries, but not as many as he did at Liverpool. Here is Lamptey, glides down the right-hand side, tries to swing the ball in, digs a cross out, nobody's there. Jorginho now brings it clear and looks further forward. He lays it into Hudson-Odoi. It's a delicate flick from him, a little scoop-up effort down the right-hand side. Pulisic gets it, looking for Lukaku. Hudson-Odoi's in so much space in the middle, but again, Brighton's defending is gutsy and determined. Lukaku floats it to the far post of Mount, headed away by Veltman. Chelsea just seem to me to be playing every single pass 5 seconds too early. I don't know why Lukaku just didn't carry that further forward. You've got every single Brighton defender trying to get back in the box. So what do they expect to be waiting for them? It's almost like they think there's nobody there in a Brighton shirt. I don't.
Yeah, there's a little bit of running through treacle here from Chelsea at the moment. It's in this second half, first 15 minutes. They look a yard slower than the Brighton side. As you said, they were back incredibly quickly then. For Lukaku's point of view, you've got two options. It's first-time ball into Hudson-Odoi and let him create something through the centre. Or, as you say, it's drive down that right-hand side, keep possession, because there's no ball then to be able to play across the penalty area. And he kind of gets stuck in two minds. And then it's a half-hearted cross in towards the far post, looking at a percentage ball to that far side. Doesn't come about, and it's a disappointing end to what was a good attack. But you look at it again, Brighton defensively just looked a yard faster and a yard more determined to get there.
Yes, Hudson-Odoi has been more determined to get there, but in doing so he's fouled his marker Bissouma, gone straight through the back of him and bundled him to the floor. Bissouma, bit of a clip of the ankles and a pull on the top of the shoulder, so he ends up on the deck. Hudson-Odoi now racing back to try and stop Cucurella, who gets across the face of goal. Crosses blocked by Jorginho. Here is March. Cucurella yet again. 65 minutes gone. He's going back towards his goal. He side-foots the pass to Veltman. Lamptey is forcing himself wide. That pass will force him even further wide, as will that touch. Of course, Lamptey, a former Chelsea Academy player, never got the chance to impress with the Blues, who were reportedly linked with trying to re-sign him. We've heard that before. As here come Brighton, a chance here to try and play it to Morpé. He can't get it to him. Morpé spins, jumps, twists, turns, almost like a gymnastic routine in frustration that a teammate, I think, took the ball off his toes. It's Dan Burn, that's the problem. It's a centre-half. Brighton take it so quick at the TV. Replayers can't catch up. And Lallana blazes the ball over the top of the crossbar from around just inside the penalty. Between the penalty spot, I think, and the edge of the box. His arm is aloft to apologise. Again, Brighton have just put everything on like an afterburner sort of mode. They're going for everything at pace. And I think it's making Chelsea look slow. That's the best. But you said running in treacle. They're making them look lethargic, aren't they?
Yeah, they absolutely are, and that's a fantastic opportunity. It's a poor first touch from Lallana, actually, to try and make the opportunity for himself. It kind of bounces up in the air, so he has to snap at it. But he's got to get that on target. Absolutely got to, as Lamptey comes off. Mwepu comes onto the field. No great surprise. Mwepu looked good a couple of days ago in the last game for Brighton, so not surprising that he's come onto the field. But the other thing I don't understand from a Brighton point of view is that March is pinging balls into the near post. Nobody's attacking that area. Here he goes again. Look, ball into the near post. There's nobody there quickly enough at the near post area. Nobody's attacking that. There's been four or five balls into that area. Chalabar's dealt with two of them in this second half. And if somebody gambles and goes across the front of the defence, Brighton could have had three or four.
Yeah, I think Lallana's just accused him of hit and hope approach with that last one, trying to blast it into the near post. It's weird, isn't it? Because we've been waiting for him for 50 minutes to put a cross in the box. He doesn't do it ever. And then he starts whipping him in every 10 seconds as Hudson-Odoi is coming off. He isn't walking fully, freely. I think he's just picked up a slight knock. I don't think he's injured. I don't think he's being replaced because he's injured. I think they're going for defensive structure here. They're tending on N'Golo Kante, who will add a bit more of a spine to the team. I think Hudson-Odoi has just run himself into the ground. He has worked tremendously hard. But again, this rather random sort of formation they're playing, their random personnel continues. You just sent a holding midfielder on for a winger.
Yeah, just the three holding midfielders now, but of course you can push Pulisic a bit further upfield now, perhaps, should you wish to do so. They probably won't initially, but he will certainly slot in down that right-hand side, you would think, and the three now through the middle will try and block off the runners through, because a lot of what Brighton have been doing is these little balls around the edge of the penalty area. Now there'll be no space for that. So, again, it comes back to, can we get Marge, can we get Cucurella, can we get players out wide into spaces that will create opportunities? They now cannot go through the middle, really, Brighton, because there will be no room with three central defenders and three sat in front of them.
Yeah, Pulisic has just been brought down by Bissouma. It's great work, that, from Pulisic. He sees the player coming. He's claiming he's being injured here. And no surprise, up to Lukaku, gets a shove from Byrne. Pulisic took them on his own, used his pace, his trickery. Gets this little slap across the chops. That's what I thought his first injury was, but it's maybe suggesting he's rolled the ankle, which just adds to Chelsea's injury woes at the minute. It's more of an impact problem. That I think he just wanted a bit more of a minute to get his breath back, and he's slow to get to his feet. He has worked hard today. It's the problem that, I know it's quite, sound like I'm being quite patronising, but it's the dirtiest I've seen his kit. And I'm just trying to say, he's more of a fancy player, isn't he? You always see him up front. He's thrown himself into challenges. He looks tired. He looks like he's worked hard. And again, he's at right wing back. That's probably why. He's put a serious shift in for his team. He's now being told to go down the line to chase his Aspilicueta throw-in. He just backheels it into play for a Brighton throw right inside their own half, right in the corner. And we have crossed this halfway point of this second half. So it will be Steve who got the commentary for the first goal. So if we're going to get another, he will be the man doing it.
As Mount puts a ball into the area, almost creates a chance straight away for Chelsea. Lead by a goal to nil. Lukaku's goal inside the first half an hour is still the one that separates the two sides, but it's been Brighton who dominated the second half. Mendy's had a couple of saves to make, you would say fairly regulation stops in that sense so far. But Brighton have dominated possession, they've dominated the attempts on goal in this second period. Chelsea still have the threat though, as they get Pulisic out wide on this right-hand side, and suddenly he's in space. His first touch lets him down, in fact he's offside anyway, it would appear. So he's brought back, so the opportunity for Chelsea disappears. Referee Mike Dean having a chat with Lukaku about what's going off, something else, something in the middle, not quite sure what. Don't think they agree, but they discuss it and come away. Wry grins from both of them in that sense. Not exactly sure what Lukaku was looking at again. It certainly can't have been offside. Oh, he's pulling him back for a pullback in the centre. That's what it is. Lukaku battling through the middle. Referee Mike Dean decided that he was holding back the defender. Didn't think Pulisic had gone too far forward. And the first look, and we were right on that. There was something off our screen that we didn't see through the middle. Lukaku has had that kind of battle on and off with the central defenders of Brighton through the half, as you'd expect. Continues to have it. This time he doesn't get the decision. He did for the goal. Brighton will debate it long and hard, I'm sure, into the night, but too late for that now. Goal has been given. VAR checked. They agreed with Mike Dean. And it was a flailing arm rather than anything else. While the two players, Lukaku and Morpé, battled inside the penalty area. There's two holds and a submission, and it was finally Lukaku who got the goal. And Sanchez has it now for Brighton, just on the edge of his own penalty. He tries to put a ball out to Cucurella. He just about manages to deal with a difficult bouncing ball. He'll have to battle back here to beat Aspilicueta. He stayed down, but as play continues around him, Mount finds Lukaku. Lukaku turns, edge of the penalty area, two turquoise shirts in front of him. Tries to play to Alonso's first touch, his trampoline, and away comes Mbeppo in the other direction. But there's plenty of dark blue shirts on this occasion back. They snuff out the danger, and all is tidied up again.
Yeah, I think Cucurella had his head stood on, or his hair, something up, amiss in back play as he wanted the chosen player to stand over him. I think he's just had, he's been trod on, but again, lack of width. I've seen it earlier, Steve, with Chelsea. on the attack. Brighton, and they had no right wing back further forward. That was the same then. Lukaku got it. Alonso should have been 15, 20 metres further forward, but here come Brighton.
Yeah, they're away through the centre at least for a moment. Mwepu trying to find space, finds Bope instead. Short ball, Chalabar will force him away from the penalty area, but Brighton have kept possession here. Modé drops the ball forward. Mwepu playing almost as another striker, just in behind Mope now. They need to throw a couple of players further forward, you feel, here, Brighton, and take the gamble as Mount gets away from Cucurella for a moment, but the fullback is back onto him straight away. Mount still manages to find Lukaku, who's been pulled and harried and nibbled and kicked and harried to the floor. And finally, Byrne is the one who's had the free kick given against him on this occasion. He complains to Mike Dean. Mike Dean, not surprisingly, tells him what he thinks. And it is the referee who prevails, and the free kick will go to Chelsea.
It is soft, to be fair. It is very, very soft. They've been at each other all night, and of all the challenges to penalise, it's that one.
Yeah, I think that's a totting up one, that one. I'll pull your shirt, I'll give you a push, I'll kick you a bit, I'll tap your ankles. All right, I think we've had enough now, and it will be a free kick. Not necessarily in a straightforwardly dangerous position as far as the Brighton defence is concerned. It's out wide on the right-hand side. Mount will have to whip this into the area as Brighton put their line on the edge of the box. Deep one towards the far post. Free header for Rudiger. And it almost falls for Alonso, but it's hooked away defensively by Brighton, and they scramble it behind for a corner.
Yeah, Veltman getting to it, doing enough at the last second to smash it clear. But free header, that's awful. Cucurella is actually watching Rudiger run away from him as if it's his teammate, saying, go on, head it. Defensive, that is a liability, that from Brighton. Really bad.
Yeah, and actually, I didn't give Veltman enough credit there. They cleared away at the near post, up towards the halfway line, but there's nobody there for Brighton, so Kovacic has plenty of time to take it down, plays it out wide to Kante, onto the edge of the box, little flick back inside, finds Mount, he tries to force his way through, Cucurella gets across, keeper was there, but as he said, I've got to take control of the situation, he pushes it behind the defender for another corner.
Lovely flick, really nice. I'm a big fan of Mason Mount. I know he gets a lot of criticism at times for some of his play. I think he's got pretty much all of it. He can finish, he works hard, terrific player. And again, his energy levels are frighteningly high, and he's, you know, got into a good position. Chelsea try to cheer him on as he gets another ball into the box here.
It'll be Mount then from the corner, left hand raised as he whips it in towards the penalty spot. Header comes in from Chalabar, easily saved by Sanchez, who races away from Lukaku to try and get the ball out quickly, but nobody available at least to begin with before he finally bowls it out onto the right hand side, and Brighton will start off forward. Long ball downfield, easily headed away by Pulisic, will fall to the feet of Kante, who chips it downfield, and suddenly Mount finds himself in a little bit of space, lays the ball back into the path of Kante coming forward, but just too many defenders around, but Kante still manages to get there a third time and win back possession somehow. And here's Kovacic for Chelsea. He'll roll it out to Alonso, chalk on his boots, left hand side, comes back inside, Jorginho has it. Brighton have reset themselves defensively, but Chelsea don't have to force the issue, of course, leading by a goal to nil, 15 minutes left to go. Here comes Kovacic, first time cross is poor, straight into the hands of Sanchez, wanders towards the edge of his box before balling it out, and again Brighton trying to come away inside the goal ready and waiting. As Brighton came forward, there was no option to get through the centre, and they've given the ball away cheaply in the end, the Seagulls, although Rudiger will have to tidy up at the back. He finds Chalabar, roll to Aspilicueta again, right-hand side. Inside to Jorginho, poor play from him though, he's lost possession, and Brighton have it through the middle, and Mwepu, under pressure from three players, manages to extract himself with the ball at his feet. Ball is rolled into the path on this occasion of Cucurella, out wide again for March. Blocked off by Pulisic, still gets a cross in, again it comes near post, again there's nobody attacking it from a Seagull's point of view, and again Chalabar heads it away as it comes towards Bissouma. He overstretches and then he stays down after a challenge in the centre of the field. Referee saw no foul at all, Mike Dean right on the spot, just a collision between Bissouma and Mount in the end. Looks like both players are back on their feet. Brighton are back in possession on the halfway line. Cucurella looks forward, just drops the ball inside for Bissouma. Mwepu makes a good run over the top, but the pass doesn't come to him. Instead, it goes short, and Chelsea are there in numbers to clear. Byrne lifts it back over the top. He just hoofs it forward in the end. And it's straight through to Mendy. 14 minutes left to go. And for me, Brighton have got to push somebody further forward.
The last 5 or 6 minutes, they're making two changes. The last 5 or 6 minutes, they haven't done much. And I think if Chelsea wised up a little bit, they could kill this game off. They've got the bodies to do it. They've just given the ball away, though. Jorginho just tried to play a pass around the side of 4 Brighton defenders. He's asking him... I know he thinks he's a Ballon d'Or quality winner, but you're asking so much of yourself. But yeah, for me, Brighton, at this current stage, aren't getting any points. So why not go for it? If they concede a second, you're still leaving with nothing as the ball comes in and Mendy catches. You know, I understand you expose yourself, but they're not offering anything. You know, if they were offering stuff and chances were aplenty, then yeah, you'd probably say, do you know what, let's just sit on this a little bit and see if we can snatch a draw. But at the minute, Mendy's making had a comfortable night at the office.
I know I'm banging on about this, but that's across the gate. As you said, Mendy takes it near post, easy catch, nobody there. So is the problem with the balls in, particularly from the left-hand side, or is it players not attacking the right place? Anyway, come back to that in a second. Mount, through for Lukaku. He tries to force it off into the run of Kovacic to his left-hand side, but this time Brighton get a challenge in. Mwepu has it, but he's lost out possession, and it goes away to Lukaku, turns away from Mwepu on this occasion. And Chelsea are coming forward in numbers, not quickly at the moment, but they do have possession at least. Wide on the left-hand side, ball back inside now, and Chelsea just taking the pace out of the game. Try and take the control into it now over these last 12 minutes or so of the match. As Brighton prepared to make what looked like a couple of substitutions, Welbeck was certainly one of them. That may be the extra attacker, although knowing the way it's gone so far, it'll be more payoff and Welbeck on likely to be the case. Here comes Jorginho in space, threads the ball to Lukaku, edge of the box. He lays it off for Pulisic, who's going away from goal though in the end. He finds N'Golo Kante. Ball played square to Jorginho, 30 yards out, miscontrols it, tries to push it then into towards the area, but Byrne makes the challenge. And away come Brighton again. Mopé's ball is poor square though, easily cleared away by Rudiger. Cucurella has to be there quickly and he's lucky. His clearance bounces back off the defender and comes back in towards Chelsea again. Off comes March over the halfway line. Ball forward, Basuma can't stretch there. It's backwards and forwards from both sides on halfway. Here comes Kovacic though, one-on-one with Veltman. He steps inside instead. Brighton have come back in numbers. Kovacic still has possession, tries to find Lukaku. Two players around him, back to Mount. His shot is kind of mishit. Cucurella sticks out a foot and pushes it behind for a corner.
Yeah, everything just seems like it's an effort. It's like what we can't see, that this pitch is made of a swamp-like surface. And everyone's having to work so much harder than we perhaps realise. Every pass is astray. It just doesn't seem like everything's clicking very well. As Welbeck now comes on for McAllister. Hopefully this gives them a bit more invention in that final third.
Yeah, need to push him forward. Upfield, you feel? Get particularly attacking, as we said. I'm bang on about it, that near post area. Somebody's got to keep going in there. Anyway, defending to be done first of all. As it will be a corner kick for Chelsea. Just over 10 minutes to go. Left-hand side. One arm raised from Alonso as he whips it in. Terrible corner again. Easily cleared away by Bissouma.
Does he get above knee height, that ball?
I'm not even sure I would class that as a corner. More of a pass across field. I'm sorry. Terrible.
I've seen ball boys pass the ball, but...
Dear, oh dear, oh dear. That was an under-12s corner, that one. Ball is... I may well be a little harsh, but I have high standards of these players. I expect more. Jorginho, ball square to Aspilicueta, somebody who does bring a little bit of class at times, and this one's a percentage ball into Lukaku, gets away from the defender, Veltman, almost chests it down. Can't do so. He was offside anyway, says the assistant on the right-hand side. The flag was up, and the opportunity goes.
Do you demand more of these birds because they could buy off our houses if they got paid this week? Is that why?
I know the quality of these players. I expect perfection every time. I you don't always get it. People are human. I accept that. But I still expect a very high standard of play.
I think if they don't make a corner and get it right, they should donate their wages to the crowd. Anything else, anything of technical skill, I'm fine with. But, yeah, currently not being able to take a corner. We've got a bit of an issue, perhaps off the ball, maybe. Interesting, there's a lot of stewards coming around the ground as well, but it's just because it's a 10-minute thing. I'm not sure. Not all grounds still do that, but a lot of Chelsea. It all got very confusing because there was players pushing and subbing. Mount's got a card. I think Bissouma's going to get a card.
Yeah, not the first time Bissouma's been involved in something, is it, in that sense? But going back to the corner, falling from a corner, right? So I expected to beat the first man as a minimum. Or if you're going to put it into that area, I expect at least two players to be attacking it. Anyway, there we are. And the ball is out of play after all that. Not sure whether Mike Dean's actually shown a card. There was a little bit, yeah, there was a bit of pushing and shoving, players grabbing shirts, nothing too nasty about it. Fourth official was right on the spot, so there may have been a yellow card for one or the other of them. We have a little pause in play. We can't really see. Bissouma is shown to have been the man who's got the yellow card, more for his reaction than anything else. Looks like Mount has, should we say, got away with it in that sense, although I don't think he was the main aggressor. He was just niggling away at the Brighton man. 8 minutes left to go. Chelsea still leading by a goal to nil. Lukaku's goal on 29 minutes is the one that separates the two sides. Half-time, as we said, in London at Brentford against Manchester City. Manchester City leading by a goal to nil. The ball is picked up in defence, as Tom very kindly shows me that Blackburn in the Championship have just gone 2-1 up in their game. Brereton Diaz has scored. He's now got more goals than the whole the opposition team for this season, quite comfortably. Blackburn leading by 2-1 in the Championship. Elsewhere, Middlesbrough 1 up at Blackpool, and Coventry against Millwall stands at 0-0.
Quite remarkable, the run that Blackburn are on, by the way.
Yes, I was rather hoping it wouldn't continue to be remarkable this evening, but it looks like
Steve,
it is.
You never know. You never know.
I do know. There's only 20 minutes left. Ball forward by Byrne. 10 minutes, less than 10 minutes in our game. 7 minutes and change is all we have left as the ball runs straight through to Mendy, deep inside his own penalty area. He will wander around with the ball at his feet, wait until Maupay comes across, and then clear the danger away. But you kind of get the feeling that all the possession and the pace and the opportunities that Brighton had in the first 20 minutes of this second half has now been really quelled by these Chelsea changes.
Yeah, I mean, you made the point about space in the middle, didn't you, when Conte come on. And they've just not done enough with the possession they have, like you said. And I'm just a little bit disappointed by some of their play. To lose 1-0 to the current European champions is no shame at all. It's probably a good result. Some teams will come here and get much more of a beating, but that lack of a second striker has let them down at times with balls into the box. But Chelsea have been nowhere near their best. They've been so sloppy at times. You can understand why Tuchel's getting a bit frustrated with his team. Again, that is a very hit and hope cross from March, though. He just kicked it in the direction of the box and hope it goes through a gap. You know, that isn't the way to do it.
But how much of it do you look at it from Tuchel's point of view and say, okay, it's not the best performance, but second game in a few days, lots of games coming up, injuries,
yeah,
COVID, etc. They've had
a win
couple
end of
weeks. You take the victory, you move on.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, I just think last few weeks, you know, it hasn't clicked at all for them. But when you actually look at it, I think they've only lost twice, maybe at best in the last 15, something like that. So, you know, it's the draws that have killed them. Liverpool and Man City haven't drawn, have they? They've just been winning week after week. Of course, barring Liverpool's defeat the other night, I know. But before that, City just a well-oiled machine that have kicked into gear. Chelsea, as it stands, are doing the same tonight by winning, but still Brighton on the front foot.
Yeah, they still have chances here as the ball is through towards March. He thinks he's offside, actually. I don't think the flag then goes up. He ends up losing possession. Aspilicueta comes across to cover. Another opportunity for Brighton to score fades away. We said it already.
Just like the referee do his job.
Absolutely.
Swing the ball in. What if they've got it wrong? I know Vaz, that, I mean, he is offside, I understand it, but just to stand there, and it's just frustrating. But again, he thinks that original pass is coming for him. He doesn't expect it to go to a shorter player. So I understand why he's set off too early, but yeah, he's so far in front.
Yeah, he's unfortunate in the end, as you say, but in that situation, you're not going to gain anything by allowing the ball to run out of play. Better to put it across, force Chelsea to at least take the free kick and get on with the game. Here comes Lukaku. Rolls it into the path of Mount, who will have to take it himself to begin with. He tries to find Kante on the edge of the box, but he can't control it. And Cucurella whips it off him and then tries to break away down the left-hand side. There's no march there this time, though, and he has to find Maupay coming out of the central positions. He loses possession. Ball breaks for Pulisic down the right-hand side. Back to Kante. Inside again for Kovacic, who gets away from the rather half-hearted challenge of Lallana. Ball into Lukaku. Oof. Turns away from the first defender. But there's a second one there with the challenge. Shot comes in. Lukaku is claiming a corner. Referee, I think, says it's gone straight out off the Chelsea man.
Yeah, I mean, it's a great turn, that, Steve. The touch is beautiful to take it away from his marker, but it's just not cute enough to stop Veltman. I think Veltman's had a great game tonight. I think he's been everywhere for Brighton when they've needed him. And it should be a goal kick. You know, it hits Lukaku last. big chance. You know, he's their man that they need to turn to get them over the line. Tuchel furious, screaming at Howe. I think that's a goal kick.
I think it's a goal kick as well. I don't have any problem with that. I think Veltman plays it under Lukaku and away it goes. It may have got a slight nick off the defender as it came back across, but for a start, there's no way Thomas Tuchel can see that from 50 yards away. I'll tell you that now. Ball forward, here comes Kante, in towards the edge of the penalty area. He tries a first-time shot. This time, Byrne is the one that gets across, and it comes off Byrne and spins away and behind for a corner kick. And with only 4 minutes left to go, plus a little bit of stoppage time that we should have, at least maybe 3 or 4 minutes of, Brighton's opportunity to get the ball forward is becoming few and far between as Chelsea try and turn the pressure on over the last 5 minutes or so. It will be a corner kick to Chelsea. Mount will come across to take it eventually. He'll take the scenic route towards the corner flag before he finally puts the corner in. Ball is already there because Bissouma had left it for him ready to take. Rudiger and a couple of others are up from the back as Mount finally raises his left arm and will whip it in with his right foot. High looping ball towards the far post, looking for Rudiger. It's headed down, comes back down into the area. Shot comes in. Aspilicueta sticks a foot out at it after Kovacic got the first strike. Aspilicueta gets a foot to it, but only succeeds in diverting the ball way over the crossbar.
Yeah, he should go for it though. He's done the right thing to try and steer it, and it's going nowhere near goal with that Kovacic shot, and he knows it. But the last two shots, by the way, were going nowhere near goal. I think Conte is going as close to the corner flag. He didn't realise that, did the Brighton defender, as Moda is going to make way for the last few moments of this match. I think Alzate was the number I thought I recognised, and it is. Bit more quality in terms of on the ball. I have been liked watching Jakub Moda when I've seen him play. I've noticed his influence on the game a lot more than I have tonight. It's just not been his game. But again, you are playing against Jorginho and Kovacic.
Yeah, certainly not the easiest game, but I think he's been overshadowed, as you say, by one or two others around him on this occasion. There will be a free kick here. Will there? No. Which way is this one going? No, the referee's waving his arms around in both directions at the minute, so I'm not exactly sure what he's given. He seems to be pointing for a Chelsea free kick rather than anything else, as we see it again. Alzate.
Nowhere.
Does he run into Kante?
Nowhere.
Not really. I don't think it's a foul either way, to be honest with you.
How is that Chelsea's foul?
I'm not sure. Anyway, on this occasion, I don't agree with the referee.
If we're going to give a free kick, it has to go the other way. He turns inside and he pushes him over.
Yeah, I agree. Wow. I think we've gone with the referee and his assistants both on VAR and the sideline for the big decisions tonight. But on this one, I'm afraid I've slightly baffled by that one. But anyway, ball breaks away. Pulisic left in a crumpled heap on the halfway line, but play continues without him as Maupay is down the left-hand side, but Chalabar is a good 5 yards quicker than Maupay, races across, slides in and knocks the ball out of play. Pulisic is miraculously back onto his feet with a minute left to go.
There's that, and I think the pass is an absolute shocker again towards, I think it was Cucurella again. I want to say that again. Bissouma, has he left his leg in on Pulisic? Has he done him dirty a little bit? I'm not sure. That was the play that went towards him anyway. Oh yeah.
A bit of a swing out by Pulisic. I'm not sure there's a deliberate tread on that occasion by Bissouma. Anyway, ball is cleared away by Chelsea to Lukaku, who's deep inside his own half. He finds Pulisic down the right-hand side. Three defenders around him, though, on this occasion. He loses possession of the ball. Bissouma whips it off him, and then he loses out as his touch is heavy. Ball forward towards Lukaku, but this time Byrne has got the right side of him and clears the ball back to his keeper Sanchez as we tick to the 90-minute mark as Chelsea lead by a goal to nil. Brighton lose possession. Referee says there's a foul though before the shot comes in on this occasion for the challenge, and there will be no decision. Lovely to see that the goal decision system still working though, as Mike Dean has his arm out and his watch is flashing goal as he does so.
That's all I want to see. That's all I want to see. It didn't work at Villa Park last year for Sheffield United, Aston Villa. No, so
technology is still working. Clear free kick, given early, but still a goal flashes. Here come Brighton, ball into the box, header comes in, and finally they have a goal at Stamford Bridge. It came out of nothing really, just a percentage ball into the area. The substitute, Danny Welbeck, rises highest and heads the ball home. Delirium for the Brighton fans. For me, they've deserved this on their second half performance, Brighton, and they finally, after all these years, have a goal and possibly a point, it looks like, at Stamford Bridge.
It's a beautiful header, Steve. It really is. It's a fantastic looping header into that far corner. Edouard Mendy's feet do not move an inch. And Chelsea have fallen asleep. How have they allowed Danny Welbeck to go walkabout in the box? It's come from nothing, really. A bit of a quick counter. They've not been bombarding them. And again, it's just that second striker. What a ball out there is. Cucurella, I should not get the beating there of Chalobah in terms of the effort. But you've got to praise, rather than criticise the defending, I think you've just got to praise the striker play. He does everything he needs to do. He's in between two defenders, bang. It's a beautiful header, is that?
Beautiful header, as you say. You might question Rudiger not getting goal side of him originally. He's actually being held down by Rudiger, who's got hold of his shirt as well, but goes up to make the header. Beautiful header, as you say. Mendy rooted to the spot, but there's a reason for that. Such a beautiful header. Does that come down as pot of magic then on the sideline for the substitution? Yeah, because we said they needed an extra player in there. He's put one on. He scored the goal.
Well, that's more me and you magic than him. We've been here for half an hour asking him. But again, your second body in the box. Neil Maupay is not going to get to that. He's not tall enough. You had someone a bit more rangy. Again, this just sums Chelsea up. They can't kill a game off. They cannot kill matches off. And lo and behold, they've conceded with a minute, three and a half minutes to go.
Yeah, they certainly have. Excellent stuff. Superb fight back from Brighton. You've got to say, as I said, I think they've been excellent in this second half. Looked like Chelsea had weathered the storm, but they now haven't. And with a lot of defensive players on from Chelsea, it'd be difficult to push forward now with two minutes left to go. Well, less than that now. 1 minute and change left as Alonso has a throw in for Chelsea deep inside the Brighton half. He throws it down to Rudiger, who pops up down by the left-hand corner flag, holds off the defender, finds Alonso again, ball chipped in towards the near post, headed away by Veltman. It'll drop in midfield for Chelsea again, ball cleared away downfield, too far for Maupay. He will race after it, but the ball will beat him and run out of play for a throw into Chelsea, just in front of Thomas Tuchel's technical area. And Aspilicueta wants somebody to come a little shorter so he can throw it long downfield. It's half cleared by Brighton. Romelu Lukaku gets the man of the match award. I think there's been one or two. I think he's had a good game, not criticising that, but I'd maybe say Basuma had the edge for me in midfield for Brighton.
I'll tell you who's been,
had
a shocker, Steve. Jorginho, absolute yes. Shocker. He hasn't made a single pass right, and it's his job.
Yeah, we'll have to see the stats on it, but I've got to agree, he's been a peripheral figure in the majority of this game so far, as Chelsea look for one last attack forward. Long ball up towards Rudiger, who stayed forward. It's headed clear, hacked downfield by March, who sits now in midfield. Welbeck will chase it down with Aspilicueta, who gets there first. Pulisic then has it. He's lost possession, though. Referee happy that play should continue as Welbeck tries to take it forward, but he has his pocket picked by Pulisic. The ball breaks for Conte up over the halfway line. Basuma gets half a challenge in. Somehow the ball again magnetically falls its way back to Conte. But as Chelsea come forward, that is the final whistle. It's been a first half goal from Lukaku. A late equaliser from Danny Welbeck. Full time, Chelsea 1, Brighton 1. I agree. I think we've gone with the referee and his assistants, both on VAR and at the sideline, for the big decisions tonight. But on this one, I'm afraid I've...